Hi, Lonnie Mackley here. I just want to talk to you a little bit today about being in control of your pain. And what I mean by that is that there are a lot of people with addictions and who have social problems, social phobias, because they want to be in control of their pain. They believed when they were very young that something happened and there was no control over the pain that was taking place over them, so they made a vow in their little heart that they would, once they could, that they would be in control of their pain when they were older. So what happens is when we get older, after that abuse has taken place or whatever traumatized you, you'll start to self-protect, and you'll build up an arsenal of different ways and things that you use to protect yourself from pain, or even to manage the unhealed pain that's still within you. Maybe some things happened as a child. It could be divorce or other abuses that took place, and you're still very damaged, but you can't just stop your body from growing. So there's a lot of adult children running around here with unhealed wounds, and you know, you may be one of them, and probably most of us are. And we make, like I said, we make vows that we're going to be in control of our pain. So one of the ways that we do that is by protecting ourselves. We shut ourselves off. We say no to a lot of people instead of yes, maybe when we should, because we don't want to be hurt. And we close ourselves off from the world, and we kind of check out of life and just decide that we don't want to play anymore. But life still goes on. And some people, of course, they take it so far that they actually take their life because they're just so afraid and so hurt from life that they don't want to be here anymore. They don't want to be part of the human race. So it can be a very serious problem, the obsession to be in control of our pain. Another way that we do it is through addictions. We take pleasure. We use it to manage and alleviate the pain that we're already in, especially if you have a physical problem along with it. A lot of people get addicted that way. Something happens to them physically, but then they just keep using the pain medication because then they realize that it also helps them emotionally, and that's how a lot of people get addicted. But we use pleasure to manage and protect ourselves from pain, and not just the pain that hasn't healed in us, but any future pain. The only problem that we run into, or one of the main problems that we run into, is that when you use pleasure, or over-pleasure really, normal pleasure is fine, but when we use over-pleasure, which is addiction, to manage and protect ourselves with pain, it always just creates more pain. And no matter whether you're overeating, or too much alcohol, or smoking, whatever it is, excess pleasure always creates excess pain in your life, which you're just going to try to use more pleasure to protect yourself from, and it's a very destructive downward spiral of a cycle that ruins people's health, that ruins their marriages, their relationships, their jobs, you name it. There's a lot of people in prison right now because they had made a vow in their life to protect themselves from pain, and they just started doing a lot of different things. They became life cheaters. They began to break the rules in life and do things their own way, because they didn't want to be hurt in life, and they wanted to take care of themselves, and it can get you into a lot of trouble. And one thing is that you can, when you're a kid and painful things happen to you, it's like a little monster that starts up in the closet that just gets bigger and bigger and bigger as you get older, and you don't want to open that closet. You don't want that closet opened up again, and these unhealed things just seem to grow inside of us that has happened to us. And God wants to, you know, take us back, and He wants to help us to face those things, face those little monsters, to show us that they're not monsters around Him, and that God can help you, that He can heal you, and that God really can protect and provide for you in life in such a way where you don't have to fear pain or fear harm anymore to such a degree that you become an idolater, which just means that you use things in place of God, maybe addictions or people, whatever it is that you're using to protect yourself in life other than God, can be an idol in your life, a false god. And so God wants to get rid of those things that don't really work. Like addiction works, seems like it works temporarily, but then it actually, like I said, it gives you more pain than pleasure in the end. But God wants to come into your life, and He wants you to be able to trust Him instead of trusting in yourself, which really doesn't work very good anyway. You probably figured that out by now. But you can really trust God. This is a scripture a couple scriptures from the Bible. This comes out of Psalms. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. Many of you that are watching right now, you're very wounded from life. There's some terrible things that have happened in your life. You're still really hurting. You go through your day, you go to work, you still deal with your family during the day, but you're really hurting inside, and you don't want to face that pain. But that's the only way that you're going to be healed, is if you let God help you to face that pain that is creating so much fear in your life, that's been driving you toward addiction and driving you toward these protectionary kinds of behaviors that almost made you like a hermit. And God wants to set you free. Jesus said that he came that you'd have life, that you'd have it abundantly, not just, you know, some miserly life where you've got to hide all the time and protect yourself. He wants you to have a good life, an abundant life. And it comes through him. This is another thing that Jesus said. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In the world you're going to have trouble. Jesus said this, and he had trouble in life too. But take heart, I have overcome the world. So in that, Jesus is saying he wants you to have peace. That's probably really what you're lacking, is that in the absence of peace, you have fear. And so Jesus wants you to have your peace through him. And I can tell you of an experience that really helped me with a lot of my fears. I had a really terrible childhood. A lot of really bad things happened. My mother was killed by a drunk driver when I was a kid. My dad was never there. And I just got bumped around as a babysitter through my family. And so I felt very insecure. I didn't trust anybody. I didn't even trust God, because I thought if God let me go through all of that terrible stuff, I certainly couldn't trust him, because who knows what else he'd put me through. So I made that vow that I would protect myself. But when God came into my life and he baptized me with this Holy Spirit, and I began to pray in the Spirit, to speak in tongues, I knew at that moment two things. One, that God knew who I was as an individual. He wasn't just this some vague thing looking over the universe. And that he really loved me, like he poured his love into me when I got baptized with the Holy Spirit. And it really helped me to not have to fear anymore, because I knew after that God would help me with my life, that if I had a problem, I could take it to him in prayer. Prayer is a wonderful tool to help alleviate fear, to help to heal your pain. And the Holy Spirit, they call him the Counselor, and he heals you from the inside out instead of the outside in. And there's many of you that are paying thousands of dollars in therapy when all you need is just the Holy Spirit, who knows all your past, he knows all your thoughts, all your pain, and he wants to heal you from the inside out. And that happens by asking Jesus Christ to come into your heart to be your Lord and Savior. You just say, Lord Jesus, come into my life, be my Lord and Savior, forgive me for my sins, and I accept you right now in Jesus' name. And then ask him to baptize you with his Holy Spirit. If you're not sure what that is, look in the book of Acts, ACTS, chapter 2 in the Bible, and also 1 Corinthians 14, 12 to 14, and it'll teach you about it. And it just gives you power to serve God. And it will give you faith to serve God, and it will give you faith to begin to face life and to have that peace, to have that faith that I'm talking about. He'll begin to heal you, and he'll just pour his love into you. And you'll no longer have to feel like you've got to be in control of your pain all the time with drugs and with all this other stuff. It's all just, you know, ways that we try to control our pain or protect ourselves from pain. God wants to be your protector. And he wants to fill you with joy. He wants to fill you with peace. So trust him today and understand that he loves you with all of his heart. He even let his own son go through pain. We need some pain in life for growth and to drive us to God. And without it, many of us, we wouldn't even give God a second thought. So let your pain drive you to God's healing today instead of ruining your life. Because these things ruin our marriages. They ruin our relationships with our kids. We transfer our fears and our pain under our kids, and God wants to break that chain of pain and break that chain of fear in your life today. And he wants you to understand that he can indeed be in control of your pain just fine. And if he gives you challenges in life, he does it only for good. It says that all things work together for good. He's not doing it to be mean or for you to feel threatened, but he will make you face your fears so that you can overcome them. So I hope this has helped you a little bit. There's groups. If you go to my YouTube homepage, you can find groups that will give you more material on this. And just understand that God wants to heal you and be in control of your pain today. Okay? Bless you, my friend. Bye-bye.